I love leg extensions. I've got some chronic knee problems, and this is one of the few exercises I can do to exercise quads that doesn't cause knee pain. And to do these leg extensions, you're going to need either a multi-purpose bench like this that has a leg attachment. I got this for 50 bucks at a garage sale, and it included 200 pounds of weight. So you either need something like this. If you don't have something like this, at the end of the video, I'll show you how you can make a setup with just common stuff you'll find around the house. Here's the basic motion. We're going to start with our legs about 20 degrees from horizontal, and then we're going to go horizontal and down. We're just going to do the last little bit of motion here. We're going to do a little experiment to show you why I recommend doing leg extensions the way I do. Now, the way I recommend doing leg extensions is starting position here and just going up the last 10 degrees or so. What you'll hear most people say is that you start with your knee at 90 degrees and go all the way up and all the way down. And with the help of this little model here, I'm going to show you why I recommend the way I do. So you'll see this is an artificial leg, cute little foot there, and the way this works, so this is the patella here, and this is the tendon, and the way the extension works is the quadricep contracts and the extension happens. So I'm going to do a quick experiment to show how much pressure is put on your kneecap, because that's what causes a lot of injury, is the pressure on the kneecap. And I'm going to show you why it's much better to do just this last 10 degrees than it is to go down all the way. Just a reminder, I'm not a medical professional. I'm an engineer. So that's why we build things with hinges. Now, we're going to use this egg as your kneecap because it's rather fragile. And what we're going to do, we're going to put the egg where the kneecap is and show how much pressure it can take without cracking. And we're going to do it the way I recommend, and then we're going to do it the way most people do. And you'll see that the egg is going to crack much easier doing it this way. So let's do our experiment. This is the calf. This is the thigh. This is the tendon, and this egg here represents the kneecap. And so the quadricep here is going to contract and cause the calf to raise. And what we're going to do, we're going to use this scale and see how much force we can put against the leg here before the kneecap cracks. So let's give that a try. Okay, 3 ounces, 5 ounces, 6 ounces, 8 ounces, 10 ounces, oh, there goes the kneecap, 10 ounces. So now let's do a comparison. Let's do it the way I suggest and have this be the starting position and see how much force it can handle without cracking. Go ahead and put some weight on here. 6 ounces, 10 ounces, this is where the other one cracked at 10 ounces, 14, 16. So there's a pound, no cracking. So we need more, try some more force. This is 40 ounces, so we're going to go ahead and apply this here. See at what point it cracks. Wow, that's holding the full 40 ounces, and it's not cracking. So this is holding 4 times as much weight without destroying the kneecap. Let's try some more weight. So this is 80 ounces. I'm pretty sure this is going to crack, but we'll see. Okay, I'm letting it go. Holy smokes. Oh! Okay. Don't let this happen to your kneecap. It's somewhere between 4 and 8 times as strong this way. So don't let this happen to you, my friend. You're only given 1 set of knees, so take care of them. When you're doing the leg extensions, please, 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 use this as your starting position, not this. So we're going to start here and just go the last little bit. and you can work out your leg just as well, and you put a lot less stress on your kneecap. Now, it's important that you don't get injured getting the setup into the start position. So you'll notice what I'm going to do here. I'm going to use my hands to lift the weight up into position before my legs even touch the pads. So that way, I'm not going to stress out my knee joint getting up to the start position. Now, you'll also notice when I'm finished with my set, I'm going to use my hand to hold the weight at the start position till I can remove my legs from under the pads, and then I'll use my hand to lower the weight instead of my legs. That way, I'm not going to get injured at the end of the set either. Another very important safety point when you're doing these leg extensions is to use a very slow motion. Up slow, down slow. You do not want to do any bouncing or jerking because that's going to definitely screw up your knees. Now let's talk about how often to work out legs. Legs are a very big, powerful muscle group. If you're a beginner, I would say work out legs twice a week. If you're intermediate or advanced, I would only work out legs once a week and I would hit them really, really hard. As far as the number of reps to do, I would keep that in the 7 to 20 rep range. And again, remember, very slow up and down. Leg extensions are a small but very important part of your leg workout, but I don't pretend that they're a complete workout in themselves. You need to combine leg extensions with many other exercises to get a complete leg workout. Now, as promised, I'm going to show you how to do leg extensions at home if you don't have a multi-purpose bench. You're going to need a strong leather belt, and you're going to need a set of dumbbells with a little homemade harness so that you can hold the weight up from the middle. You're going to need a chair that is nice and deep so it supports your entire upper leg, and some books to make it the right level. So the way we're going to do this, we're going to sit with our knee right over the edge of the chair, and then we're going to attach our ankle to the dumbbell with the belt, and this belt needs to be really strong. I'd only recommend leather because you don't want this coming undone. Make sure it's securely fastened. And you're going to adjust the height with these books such that your starting position is about 20 degrees from horizontal. And then you're going to do the leg extension motion just like we did with the multi-purpose machine. For those of you who do leg extensions in the gym, many of these machines don't have adjustable starting positions. So to keep from getting injured, what you need to do is remove the weight pin and then put your legs in the proper position so they're about 20 degrees down from horizontal, and then put in the weight pin.